Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab series, covering voltage reference considerations for SAR ADCs. The goal of this section is to take a close look at the importance of having a wide bandwidth buffer between the reference and the ADC input. We will compare and contrast measured results showing the importance of the buffer. Finally, we will highlight some devices with integrated buffers that can be used to simplify your design. In this video, an overview of different SAR ADC reference drive circuit topologies will be presented. First, we will define what we mean by a reference buffer. Then, we will compare a buffered and unbuffered reference. Finally, we will also look at how some devices integrate reference buffers. The term reference buffer is used to describe a wide bandwidth amplifier used between the reference and the ADC input. The reference buffer responds to the very fast transient current requirements on the switch capacitor ADC reference input. Note that multiple transients from the reference input can be milliamps in amplitude and are spaced in nanoseconds. Besides having wide bandwidth, a good reference buffer needs to have low output impedance across frequency. Furthermore, it needs to be capable of sourcing and sinking relatively large currents. For example, plus or minus 10 milliamps. Also note that any reference buffer will need to have good DC performance. That is, the reference buffer will need to have low offset and offset drift. Finally, the reference buffer can be integrated into the reference, or it may be an external amplifier. The figure shown here demonstrates an external amplifier buffer. Note that all series voltage references will have some type of internal buffer. In many cases, however, this buffer doesn't have sufficient bandwidth or current drive capability to directly drive an ADC reference input and achieve good settling performance. Thus, when we refer to a reference buffer in this presentation, we are specifically referring to a wide bandwidth buffer that is capable of driving a SAR ADC reference input and achieving good settling. The figure below shows a reference buffered with an external wide bandwidth amplifier. The next logical question you might ask is, when is a reference buffer required? The buffer requirement depends primarily on two factors, the output drive capability of the reference and the SAR ADC input current demand. The SAR ref input current demand tends to be a function of the sampling rate and resolution of the ADC. As the sampling rate increases, the average reference input current demand will tend to increase. It is important to understand that the reference input current in the traditional SAR ADC is not a static or constant DC current. Rather, the reference input current consists of fast current transients as the binary weighted bit decisions are made. We will cover more detail on this later. Also note, the higher resolution SAR ADCs will tend to have more demanding reference specifications. This is because the reference voltage input must remain stable and settle to less than 1 LSB. For example, a 12-bit ADC using a 5-volt reference has a least significant bit weight, or LSB, of 1.22 millivolts. In contrast, a 16-bit device has a smaller bit weight resolution of 76 microvolts, imposing a much more stringent requirement. When designing a data acquisition system, the first step is to check the SAR ADC datasheet for guidelines. Most ADC datasheets provide a circuit recommendation optimal to support the maximum data rate. However, depending on the sampling rate requirements and the reference device used in the application, a detailed analysis or simulation may be required to verify that you will meet the performance target. Let's look at a few example circuits. First, let's consider a case where the performance is degraded because we didn't use a reference buffer. Here, we show the REF5050 connected to the ADS8860, a 16-bit, 1 mega sample per second converter. In this example, we will see degraded performance because the reference does not have a sufficient bandwidth to respond to the transient current demand of the ADC. In this circuit, the REF5050 device is not able to recover and recharge the bypass capacitor between conversions, and the voltage droop and settling errors occur at the SAR ref P input between conversions. These voltage reference settling errors cause linearity and distortion in the conversion result. Note that the sampling rate and resolution have an impact on the reference bandwidth requirement. In this example, the ADS8860 is a 1 megasample per second 16-bit ADC, which is relatively fast and high resolution, so a wide bandwidth buffer is needed. Let's take a look at the measured results. This plot shows the FFT results of the ADS8860 sampling at 1 megasamples per second with the ref 5050 reference driving the ADC without a buffer. Comparing the SNR and THD of the specifications, you can see that the measured THD of negative 91.3 dB is significantly degraded compared to the expected THD of negative 108 dB. Also, if you look at the FFT, you will notice a relatively large second and third harmonic. In the next slide, we will resolve this issue by placing a reference buffer with enough bandwidth and low output impedance to drive the reference input. This figure shows a very similar configuration to the last circuit. The data converter and test conditions are the same for both circuits. The only change is that the ref 5050 was replaced with the ref 6050. Both devices are precision, low noise, low drift references with very similar specifications. The main difference between the two references is that a wide bandwidth buffer is used at the output of the ref 6050. This buffer has low output impedance across frequency and was optimized to drive a switched capacitor reference input. One key benefit of using a device like the ref 6050 is that the PCB board area and complexity is reduced compared to a discrete reference buffer. In fact, both the ref 6050 and ref 5050 are pin-to-pin compatible. So let's see how the ADS8860 performance is impacted by changing the reference. Here, we compare the ADS8860 performance with the two different references. First, note that the data converter specifications are 93 dB for SNR and negative 108 dB for THD. Ideally, our measured system should meet the datasheet specifications. If it doesn't meet the specifications, it is likely that some external component, such as a reference, is a limiting factor. The plot on the left shows a performance with the ref 5050. Although this reference is a precision low noise low drift reference, you can see that the THD is significantly degraded compared to specification. According to the specification, we should get negative 108 dB, but we only get negative 91.3 dB. The plot on the right, on the other hand, shows a performance for the ref 6050. Comparing the FFTs, you can see that the harmonics for this system is significantly improved. Also, comparing the measured SNR and THD for the specification, you can see that we are very close to the specification. The main point here is that the reference with a wide bandwidth buffer is able to achieve a better distortion specification because it can settle to the large rapid transients at the reference input. Next, let's look at how sampling rate can impact the reference drive requirements. Here, we show an example where a wide bandwidth reference isn't always needed. Recall from the previous example that the ref 5050 did not have an integrated wide bandwidth output buffer, so we saw degraded performance when this reference was used at 1 megasamples per second. Here, we are using a different data converter, the ADS8326. Which is a 16-bit device with a maximum sampling rate of 250 kilosamples per second. Using this data converter with the ref 5050 actually yields very good performance. This is because the relatively slow sampling rate of 250 kilosamples per second allows the ref 5050 to completely recharge the bypass capacitor with the time interval between conversions. For best performance, it is important to use a relatively large bypass capacitor. The ref 5050 is capable of driving large capacitive loads. Also, choosing a reference that can source and sink significant current is important. The ref 5050, for example, can source plus or minus 10 milliamps. Be sure to check the capacitive drive and output current specification in the reference datasheet, as some references will be limited. Note that for this example configuration, the ADS8326 can meet the datasheet, THD, and SNR specification without a wideband buffer. In cases where you need a reference buffer, from a simplicity perspective, you would like to use a simple op-amp unity gain follower as shown on the left. The problem with the simple design is that the buffer needs to have both good AC and DC characteristics. The offset and offset drift need to be low, or the precision of the reference is lost. Also, the bandwidth needs to be high, and the output impedance needs to be low and flat across frequency. Most amplifiers are either optimized for AC or DC characteristics, so finding the ideal reference buffer can be challenging. One way to solve this problem is to use a composite amplifier. A composite amplifier will use two op-amps, one that is optimized for good DC operation, and the other that is optimized for bandwidth. One example of a composite amplifier is shown on the right. The OPA378 input amplifier is a chopper amplifier. Chopper amplifiers offer excellent DC precision as they continuously self-calibrate the offset and offset drift. In this case, the offset is 50 microvolts and the drift is 0.25 microvolts per degree Celsius. However, the bandwidth and output impedance for this device are not sufficient for driving the reference input. The OPA625 output amplifier offers high bandwidth of 125 MHz with very low output impedance over frequency, capable of driving the SAR ADC dynamic load. Since the OPA378 is used at the input of the feedback loop, the offset and drift errors of the OPA625 are corrected, and the OPA625 at the output of the composite can still respond to the rapid transients of the ADC. So, the composite essentially gets the best of both worlds. It has the good DC characteristics from the OPA378 and the good AC characteristics from the OPA625. After inspecting the circuit, you might be dissuaded from using it because of its complexity. However, to achieve the highest performance at high data rates, this may be required. Frequently, the ADC datasheet will provide recommendations for ADC drive circuits. So check the datasheet before choosing your topology. Many modern SAR ADCs incorporate internal references and reference buffers. This slide shows the high-performance ADS8900B, a SAR ADC offering a very high 20-bit resolution at a fast sampling rate of 1 megasample per second. In this case, the output of the voltage reference connects to a high-impedance buffer input. Thus, the voltage reference does not see any transients from the ADC. This convenient feature allows multiple ADC devices to be connected to a single voltage reference. This approach simplifies calibration and reduces the system complexity. Note that each device requires a local bypass capacitor at the reference buffer output. Another nice benefit of the reference buffer is that the reference can have a traditional RC noise reduction filter connected to its output. If you look at this example, the 1K ohm and the 10 microfarad filter limit the noise to 159 Hz. It is not possible to use this kind of filter without the buffer, as the 1K ohm resistor would limit its ability to respond to the large current transients from the reference input. In general, modern ADCs tend to integrate more of these convenient features, simplifying your design and reducing PCB area. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content.